Many of us watch TV or play games on our phones at night to unwind and switch into rest mode. But more and more research says watching TV in bed or falling asleep in front of the TV is really bad for your health. With all the streaming services releasing full seasons all at once, it's easy to get sucked in and say, just one more, until suddenly it's 3 a.m. and you've spent half of your night yelling at Dustin and the Demogorgon. Then, when you do finally crawl into bed, you probably toss and turn and can't sleep because not only are you staying up and getting all riled up, but the light coming out of the TV itself is secretly messing with your body clock. Humans naturally have a roughly 24-hour circadian cycle. For night owls, it's a little longer, and for early birds, it's a little shorter. For humans, the cycle is highly influenced by light. Evolution tells us that when it's light out, we're awake, and when it's dark, we're asleep, which makes light a driver of our internal body clock. Electric lighting has sort of knocked all this out of whack, but the devices that we use, they have an even stronger effect. So why you can't sleep after you watch Leslie Knope get recalled isn't just your frustration, but also specifically the type of light that the TV is emitting. TVs are mainly LCDs or LEDs, which emit a lot of high-frequency blue wavelengths of light. Blue wavelengths boost attention and reaction time, but blue light also has the strongest ability to offset our body clocks. A certain type of photoreceptor cell in our eyes called melanopsin retinal ganglion sends signals to the suprachiasmatic nucleus, essentially the brain's master clock. Blue light tricks it into thinking it's daytime. When hit with blue, the SCN suppresses secretion of the hormone melatonin that helps us sleep and affects a host of other factors. And it's not just TVs. Tablets, phones, and laptops all have this same blue light problem. As more and more of us take our phones to bed and text or check Instagram late at night, we're getting the same blue light effects. I know a lot of people use TV or scrolling social media to relax their brains at night. It's one of the most passive activities we can do. But even though it's good for relaxing, it's not actually good for falling asleep. Blue light can delay your REM cycle enough to disrupt sleep, and if you're staying up later to watch TV, the little sleep you're getting is going to be worse quality, which can lead to a bunch of other problems. And sadly, our devices aren't the only culprits. Energy-efficient lighting also emits more blue wavelength light, which raises a separate environmental concern at odds with personal health. The solution could be as simple as the right protection against blue light for night owls. Filters that cut blue light in favor of a reddish tint, you can actually get them for your phone or computer. Or you could just do my favorite thing, reading a real paper book before bed. For more science in your world, be sure to subscribe to Seeker. And if you're curious about what happens when those TV binges go on, Jules has the details on what sleep deprivation does in this video. And in case you're wondering, watching TV on your laptop in bed, just as bad, not a loophole. Thanks again for watching.